thank you all for being here for this beautiful occasion, for coming, some of you from a long ways away, but all of you for the same reason, to give support and love, to stand with Jeremy and Molly in this beautiful coming together of their lives and commitment of their lives. Doesn't the world have enough of people standing against each other? And so you come here to stand with them and for them as they come to stand for each other and with each other. So your presence means a lot to me. This helps this be a wedding ceremony, a really meaningful time for uniting their lives for good. So thank you for being here. We'll begin with three poems by Khalil Gibran. The first on reason and passion. Speak to us of reason and passion. And he answered, saying, your soul is oftentimes a battlefield upon which your reason and your judgment wage war against passion and your appetite. Would that I could be the peacemaker in your soul, that I might turn the discord and the rivalry of your elements into oneness and melody. But how shall I, unless you yourselves be also the peacemakers, nay, the lovers of all your elements? Your reason and your passion are the rudder and the sails of your seafaring soul. If either your sails or our rudder be broken, you can but toss and drift, or else be held at a standstill in mid-seas. For reason, ruling alone, is a force confining, and passion, unattended, is a flame that burns to its own destruction. Therefore, let your soul exalt your reason to the height of passion, that it may sing, and let it direct your passion with reason, that your passion may live through its own daily resurrection, and like the phoenix, rise above its own ashes. I would have you consider your judgment and your appetite, even as you would two loved guests in your house. Surely you would not honor one guest above the other, for he who is more mindful of one loses the love and the faith of both. Among the hills, when you sit in the cool shade of the white poplars, sharing the peace and serenity of distant fields and meadows, then let your heart say in silence, God rests in reason. And when the storm comes and the mighty wind shakes the forest, and thunder and lightning proclaim the majesty of the sky, then let your heart say in awe, God moves in passion. And since you are a breath in God's sphere and a leaf in God's forest, you too should rest in reason and move in passion. And then speak to us of friendship. Your friend is your needs answered, is your field which you sow with love and reap with thanksgiving, and he is your board and your fireside. For you come to him with your hunger, and you seek him for your peace. When your friend speaks his mind, you fear not the nay in your own mind, nor do you withhold the lie. And when he is silent, your heart ceases not to listen to his heart. For without words, in friendship, all thoughts, all desires, all expectations are born and shared with joy that is unacclaimed. When you part from your friend, you grieve not, for that which you love most in him may be clearer in his absence, as the mountains to the climber is clearer from the plain. And let there be no purpose in friendship save the deepening of the spirit. For love that seeks aught but the disclosure of its own mystery is not love, but a net cast forth, and only the unprofitable is caught. And let your best be for your friend. If he must know the ebb of your tide, let him know its flood also. For what is your friend that you should seek him with hours to kill? Seek him always with hours to live. For it is his to fill your need, but not your emptiness. And in the sweetness of friendship, let there be laughter and sharing of pleasures. For in the dew of little things, the heart finds its morning and is refreshed. And finally, what of marriage? And he answered, saying, you were born together, and together you shall be forever. You shall be together when white wings of death scatter your days. Aye, you shall be together even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness, and let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together, and be joyous, but let each one of you be alone. Even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver, the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping, for only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together, for the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's You'll want to know that the vows we share together then are the personal vows of Jeremy and Lolly, written straight from their hearts and their experience together. So really, like the bond of this marriage, a thing that seals what this commitment is about. So hear these words like you're hearing their very hearts, affirming that commitment together. First of all, Jeremy's vows. Lolly, my gold and silver, my sun and moon, my sea, my sky, my autumn eve. With you by my side, I find life's fears fall to the floor. I will remember that meant to be isn't fable fodder. I will remember that shoes are your heart's currency. I promise to invade your space, whether as your personal heater or just to park too close to your face. When you're afar, I will always wish you were here. And if you ask, we'll travel all you ask. I promise to buy you pokey so long as you dance. I will always say yes. You are my treasured dinner date. I will love your art because I love your heart. I will always be your devil's advocate, your cheap date. Cheap date. boys began for sunshine play and ready to chase you into the night. My sun and moon, my autumn eve, you remind me to let today embrace the past with remembrance and the future with longing. So, Jeremy, can you commit to these vows?
Yes.
In Molly's vows to Jeremy, I'm proud of you and I'm proud of our relationship. I'm proud of our 4 years and how we've handled all the changes, good and bad. I'm grateful for my growth and I'm grateful for your growth. I see us both working so hard on this relationship, and it gives me security and hope for our future. I promise to push you through open doors, even when you are uncomfortable or fearful of the outcome. I promise to not submit to you, but compromise with you instead. I promise to always keep you laughing. I promise to never let you wait until the last minute. When we're rich, I promise to buy you that Porsche we talked about. I promise to be your sugar queen. I promise to keep challenging you emotionally. I promise to keep picking up your songs. And I promise to keep hiding them when I get angry. Like I've said many times before, I'm glad that I am me and that you are you. And most of all, the reason why I love you is when I'm scared and it's dark, you are my night light. I love you. So Molly, do you commit to these vows? Then for the exchanging of the rings, you give but little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give of yourself that you truly give. These rings exchanged today are symbols of that gift. So you came here today to offer your commitment of support and love to this commitment and support. So even when the party is done and when this night is over, don't let this be the last time. Keep on standing with them and for them as they stand with and for each other. So I now present to you Jeremy and Molly.
Thank you.
I said, please, please.
I guess this is the occasion that the
Thank you. Decision would have wound up with this not happening. And I've never been a guy of faith or anything like that, but you know, had I not gone to Ben Franklin and met Paul, you know, had I not moved to Austin and met Jeremy, this moment that we're all sharing in wouldn't have happened. And I think that it's important as we live our lives to think about those decisions we make, because you might wind up with something as gorgeous as this. Here's to that.
I feel like I now have a son, and I have more children, and as Solo pointed out the other day, I got another kid, and I didn't have to go through labor. It's really good. So welcome to the family. You've always been part of the family, and like I said yesterday, it was a, when I met you, I went, well, there you are. Because we've been waiting for you.
I think Katie has a special presentation. Katie has a special presentation.
Yeah. Hot batteries.
Yeah. got it? That looks good?
Look at that red light.
That's a good thing. Bright?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, he's happy. All right, let's go.
All right.
Let's do this.
All right. Are we doing a test?
We can cut it for him now.
Arms down.
I ain't taking that yet. You got the rest of it out.
In film class, and that knife looks just like the one in Psycho.
The white handle and everything?
Yeah, well, the size and shape.
Yeah, exactly.
The one thing you forgot, you're supposed to get a little ceremonial tape cutting knife. You forgot about that.
No, we'll go back to sleep. Listen, I didn't want a guest book. I didn't want a cake
knife. Well, I went back in the back. It's like, great.
That was awesome.
It's a great visual.
All right. Well, I'm going to go get the DJ.
Molly and Jeremy, I want you to know how much of a pleasure it has been to be with you on this great occasion. I have enjoyed it thoroughly, and you have given me a wonderful introduction to New Orleans and to Molly, your life here in New Orleans, and we are so happy to have you part of the Winter family.
Molly and Jeremy, it's been a great day, and it's been a great wedding, and I'm glad I didn't embarrass you about teasing you about how quickly you can have grandchildren, although I'll make a record of it that I want one of each, okay? You can name them Jackson and Ginger, that's fine, but I want one of each. We love you very much.
Hi, Kate and Molly. I just want to say, you look so pretty tonight, and you look handsome, Jeremy. And I just want to wish the very best of everything for both of you, because I love you. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Molly, Jeremy, this has been a long time coming, and, you know, we all knew it was going to happen eventually. And I think back to that moment that Katrina hit when Molly was in Austin and we were at Shakespeare's just getting drunk at 3 watching that hurricane come destroy our city. And, you know, Molly, you moved to Austin and that was the end of that. And, you know, it's a rare moment that something like a hurricane can be so important in bringing two people together the way that it did. And, you know, your relationship's been a little bit like that. And that's what makes it so dynamic and so amazing. And I just look forward to getting old and watching you guys together and raising a family and, you know, having your kids that I can take out when I'm the old cool uncle. So, you know, let's just have a good time for the little bit time that we have left on this earth. And I love you both so much.
Hello, Molly and Jeremy. I guess my sister and my new brother-in-law. I'm so beyond thrilled that the two of you managed to find each other, and you couldn't be more perfect for each other. And I'm so happy, so beyond thrilled about how the two of you turned out together. I love you both dearly, and I wish you the best marriage. And thanks for getting me off the hook. And we can't wait for some little blonde-haired, blue-eyed children to follow. So I love you both. This has been wonderful, and you both look great today. So love you. Bye.
Hey, Molly. Hey, Jeremy. I'm really happy to be here. I came all the way to California, of course. I hope that you come to my wedding in Italy, which you probably will. I remember, Molly, when you first started dating Jeremy and you came to visit me in Italy before when I was studying abroad, and you were already so smitten that you couldn't, you didn't even want to hang out. You wanted to just keep calling Jeremy. You were so in love. It was perfect. And you'd only been dating for a few weeks, and we already knew, everybody in the family already knew that he was the one for you. You knew he was the one for you, and I'm really happy that you guys found each other, and I love you both, and I wish you the most in life, and take care.
Hi, Molly. I'm trying to think of something to say, and all I can think about was when you and Katie were 2 and 4, and I babysat for you, and your mom said to watch out for the little one. And I thought, oh, this little girl with blonde hair and curly blonde hair and blue eyes, how can I have to watch out for her? So I was taking care of Katie, and Katie started laughing, and I turned around, and there you were in your high chair with a bowl of cereal on your head and milk all over the place. So that's what I was thinking about. But really, what I was also thinking about is the first time that you had been with Jeremy for quite a while, and the first time I met him, and your mother said, oh, I can't wait for you to meet him. This one's great. This is the one. And he was so sweet, and the two of you were wonderful together, and I'm so happy, and I don't wish you well. I know that it's going to be wonderful. I love you.
Molly and Jeremy, I am so happy to be here, and I just wanted to wish you the best of luck for many happy years together. I will never forget Molly coming to the beach shop more than 4 years ago and talking about you. She was dating someone else at the time, and it wasn't that big of a deal, but all she ever called you was her future husband, and we all thought it was kind of funny in the beginning. But I don't think it's funny now, because the second I met you, I understood why she called you that. And even, it's like she knew before she was even ready to accept it. She knew. So I'm inspired by that. Being here tonight and seeing your love for each other has even added to how much you guys inspire me. So I'm really proud of you, and I'm really happy for you, and I wish you the best. I'm happy to be a part of your life and get to watch your love grow for each other. So thank you for having me here today. Mwah! Love you.
All right, Molly and Jeremy, I just want to say you had a beautiful wedding, and I love you both, and congratulations. And you guys are so perfect for each other, and I'm so happy for you, and I love you so much. All right.
Oh, Classic rock and roll never hurt nobody. Little ditty about Jack and Diane. Two American kids growing up in the heartland. Jack gonna be a football star. Diane's debutante backseat of Jackie's car. Some of y'all know it, I can see it. Sucking on chili dogs outside of Tasty Freeze. Diane's sitting on Jackie's lap, he's got his hands between her knees. Jackie said, hey Diane, let's run off behind the shade trees. Dribble off those Bobby Brooks, let me do what I please. Oh yeah, life goes on. Oh yeah, the thrill of living is gone. Oh yeah, life goes on. Oh yeah, the thrill of living is gone. I walk on. His head and does his best James Dean. Well, now that time you ought to run up to the city. Diane says, baby, you ain't missing nothing. And Jackie says, oh yeah, life goes on. Long after the thrill of living is gone. Oh yeah, life goes on. Long after the thrill of living is gone. So let it rock, let it roll, let the bottle bounce, come and save my soul. Six. Ladies and gentlemen, give my hand. Booyah!
Booyah!
Check, 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 check.
Be afraid, for I won't be afraid. Nicely done. Give him a hand, everybody. Check, check. Check, 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 check. One, two, two mics for you, ladies.
We will rock you. Thank you.